Hello and welcome. You're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for global Indians. We broadcast news from India, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati languages. And our portal and apps have a list of well-established businesses and resources that every global Indian needs. I am Sangram Singh Rathore and today's headlines are: In India, PM Modi has slammed the Congress for not backing Muslim women. And India has inaugurated the world's largest visa center in Bangladesh. In Punjab, at least one person dies a drug-related death in the state every day. And a wanted Gurdaspur criminal has been killed in an encounter. In Canada, PM Justin Trudeau has lost thousands of Twitter followers and Kinder Morgan has cut the net price for the Trans Mountain Pipeline. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, Canada and Punjab.
Get the mortgage that's best for you from Abdul Kaiser, Principal Broker of Ingenious Mortgages. We offer first and second mortgages and refinancing. We deal with multiple lenders. We also conduct the REMIC course and exam to become a mortgage agent in just 1 week at our location. Call us at 416-887-9196 or log on to www.ingeniousmortgages.ca.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: PM Narendra Modi has taken a jibe at Congress President Rahul Gandhi for his reported remark that Congress is a party of Muslims. He asked Gandhi to clarify whether his party belonged to only male members of the Muslim community. He slammed the Congress for not speaking out on issues like triple talaq that concern Muslim women. Home Minister Rajnath Singh has inaugurated the world's largest state-of-the-art visa center with modern facilities, promising shorter waiting times for applicants in Dhaka. Bangladeshis constitute one of the largest numbers of visitors from a single country to India. A Kolkata court has summoned Congress leader and former Union Minister Shashi Tharoor. This is for his remark that the BJP will pave the way for creation of a Hindu Pakistan if voted to power again. The Congress has thrown a taunting tweet at PM Narendra Modi seeking his comments on the arrest of dear friend former Pakistan Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif and his daughter on corruption charges. The BJP responded with a jibe that all Congress leaders out on bail will be in jail soon. President Ramnath Kovind has nominated eminent classical dancer Sonal Mansingh, academician Rakesh Sinha, Dalit leader Ram Shakal and artist Raghunath Mahapatra to the Rajya Sabha. The NDA will now be in a better position to tackle the Congress-led opposition. Former Gujarat Chief Minister Shankar Sen Waghela's son Mahendra Sen, a two-time Congress MLA, has joined the BJP. On July 3rd, senior leader Kunwarji Bawalia had quit the Congress and joined the ruling party in the state. At least three valuers who regularly assisted the Income Tax Department in assessing the value of diamonds and other precious stones have turned out to be major kingpins in a diamond import scam. It is estimated to be more than Rs 2,000 crore. One of the two Malankara Orthodox Church priests who are on the run facing charges of sexual abuse of a parishioner have approached the Supreme Court seeking relief from arrest. Another accused is expected to do the same on Monday. India's star shuttler PV Sindhu overcame Indonesian Gregoria Mariska Tunjung in three games on Saturday. With this, she set up the Thailand Open women's single final against reigning world champion Nozomi Okuhara of Japan. Bollywood star Kareena Kapoor is currently in London with her son Taimur Ali Khan and actor husband Saif Ali Khan. She has been painting the city red with her friend Priyanka Singha, who also happens to be Vijay actor Ranvijay Singha's wife. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from Punjab and Canada follows.
When you are buying or selling a house or a business, you need proper guidance. We at JP Mellon Law Firm have the knowledge and the expertise to help you close your transaction hassle-free. For all your real estate needs, give us a call. When you are buying or selling a house or a business, you need proper guidance. We at JP Mellon Law Firm have the knowledge and the expertise to help you close your transaction hassle-free. For all your real estate needs, give us a call.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: At least one death is registered in Punjab due to drugs every day. It is the average for the past 2 months. Statistics since May 15th reveal drugs as the cause of death in the post-mortem reports of more than 60 young men at government hospitals. Wanted criminal Sunny Masih of Gurdaspur has been killed and two others arrested in an encounter with Punjab police in Himachal Pradesh, Bilaspur district. Five criminals had snatched a Verna car from a person at gunpoint in Mohali district. Since then, the cops had been tracking them. The General House meeting of the Phagwara Municipal Corporation has adopted a signed resolution censoring Punjab local bodies Minister Navjot Singh Sidhu. He has allegedly ignored the mayor as well as the corporation during the inauguration of a car parking and auditorium on June 15th. The Aam Aadmi Party has claimed that Punjab jails have no program for reforming or rehabilitating inmates after acquiring information under the RTI Act. The opposition party also claimed that jails are also overcrowded. The Akal Takht has appealed to the masses to join hands in the crusade against drug abuse. The appeal came a day after Chief Minister Amrinder Singh had sought Takht Jathedar Gyani Gurbachan Singh's intervention in tackling drug menace. Reconciliation between the top brass of the BJP and SED could lead to a partnership beyond Punjab's borders. For the first time, the alliance partners are likely to contest the assembly polls together in Haryana and Rajasthan. The Maharashtra government's move to induct 6 members into the Takht Hazur Sahib board at Nanded has invited the SGPC's ire. President Gobind Singh Longowal has said that it was a deliberate attempt to take control of the board. The state has signed MOUs worth ₹455.34 crore with 9 prominent industries during a one-day Punjab apparel and textile conclave. Cabinet Minister for Industry and Commerce Sundar Sham Arora has urged industrialists to invest in Punjab. The state will offer a free ride to school-going children for an indefinite period on the project's air-conditioned buses of BRTS. Also, adults can avail this facility for 3 months after the BRTS relaunch, scheduled for October 15th. Veteran playback Shahid Malia has said that Punjabi music is soulful and eternal. Shahid had recently sung Jalwa e Jubli along with singer Richa Sharma. Malia emphasized that the song brings out a sense of Punjab's land and culture. He added that the overall experience of singing Punjabi songs is great. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Canada follows. Scans
Accounting. A team of highly professional accountants, we deliver quality and immeasurable assistance to our clients. For Canada audit assistance and your business loans, the only name you can trust. A professional accountant always makes a difference. For more information, call us at 416-741-0801 or visit us at scansaccountants.com.
Welcome back to IndianTimesDaily.com and the top 10 headlines from Canada are: PM Justin Trudeau, former PM Stephen Harper and NDP leader Jagmeet Singh have lost thousands of Twitter followers as the social media giant moves to purge fake accounts. Trudeau lost 30,000 followers between July 11th and July 13th. Harper account lost 20,000 followers while Singh's follower count dropped by 15,000. Kinder Morgan Canada has stated that the actual price the federal government will pay for its Trans Mountain Pipeline expansion project will be less than $4.5 billion. The company estimated to pay at least $325 million in capital gains taxes to the Canadian government when the deal is concluded. PM Justin Trudeau is expected to shuffle his cabinet next Wednesday as his government readies for the next election amid shifting federal-provincial relations. This would be an opportunity for Trudeau to get his front bench ready and weed out anyone not contesting in 2019. A meeting between Canada's federal and provincial immigration ministers has ended bitterly with sharp exchange of words. Federal Immigration Minister Ahmed Hussein openly criticized Ontario's Minister Lisa McLeod for what he called a dangerous and un-Canadian approach to the issue of asylum seekers. Federal NDP leader Jagmeet Singh has been encouraged to run for parliament in the newly vacated BC riding of Burnaby South, but he won't be making an announcement yet. Singh spent a day in Metro Vancouver with 2 planned events in the riding that NDP MP Kennedy Stewart vacated last month. The father of a girl who died after a suicide attempt that followed months of bullying and an alleged sexual assault is extremely angry over Ontario government's new move. The Ford government has decided to revert back to province sex education curriculum taught in 1998, excluding topics such as same-sex marriage, masturbation, online bullying and sexting. The Ontario government is planning to cancel more than 750 renewable energy contracts in a bid to save the province's taxpayers a few extra dollars on their hydro bills. Minister of Energy Greg Rickford claimed that the cancellations would result in taxpayers saving of $790 million. Health Canada has announced a crackdown on licensed medical marijuana producers who are sponsoring music festivals and other events. The federal department noted that cannabis companies have been dabbling in various forms of marketing that raise red flags, highlighting music festivals as a particular point of concern. The Supreme Court has ruled that British Columbia does not have to give Philip Morris International Tobacco Company access to detailed provincial health databases. This is the latest development in a 17-year-old effort by British Columbia to recoup smoking-related healthcare expenditures from tobacco companies. Actress Grace Duff stars in a new post-apocalyptic Netflix thriller, How It Ends, now released worldwide. The actor rose to international prominence when she appeared alongside Leonardo DiCaprio in the critically acclaimed 2015 film The Revenant. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-Canadian businesses and resources from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Welcome to the Field Fresh Supermarket. One-stop shop for fresh vegetables, fruits, bakery products, Indian and Chinese grocery and much more. Visit us today at 5661 Steeles Avenue East in Scarborough, major intersection Steeles and Middlefield. Check out our weekly flyers. Field Fresh Supermarket, always fresh.
In the ongoing biopic trend, actor Ajay Devgan grabbed two films, in one of them is a biopic. Both the films are based on different people. Firstly, Ajay will star in Chanakya, a Neeraj Pandey directorial on the life and teachings of political strategist, economist and royal advisor Chanakya. Golmaal again actor who is looking forward to his first film with Neeraj Pandey commented, "I'm truly looking forward to playing Chanakya. I have followed Neeraj Pandey's work closely and I know Neeraj will tell this story with the clarity and passion with which it needs to be told." Ajay will also bring to life the story of legendary football coach Syed Abdul Rahim on the big screen through a biopic. Rahim's biopic will be produced by Boni Kapoor. On getting Ajay on board, Boni said, "An actor like Ajay is most apt for essaying this character. We hope that the film inspires millions of youngsters and soon India plays in the World Cup and becomes a potent force in world football." It seems that the next 2 years are going to be super hectic for Ajay with the films like Total Dhamal, Sons of Sardar, The Battle of Saragadi and Love Ranjan's untitled film with Ranbir Kapoor. Well, we all are looking forward for Ajay's these Bollywood flicks.
Immigration Terminal, the specialist for visitor visa, student visa, business immigration, family sponsorship, work permits, PNP programs, live-in caregivers and LMIA applications. Highly experienced in cases involving criminal or medical admissibility and previously refused or misrepresentation cases. Call 416-675-5666 in Ontario or 778-927-3455 in BC. Email us at info@immigrationterminal.ca. Immigration Terminal, right consultants, right future.
Yesterday, choreographer-filmmaker Farah Khan posted a photograph of herself along with the actors Akshay Kumar, Bobby Deol and Ritesh Deshmukh, whom she described as handsome men and who will play a lead in the film. Now, Farah Khan posted a picture of herself with actresses Kriti Sanon, Pooja Hegde and Kritik Harbanda, whom she calls lovely ladies. Farah on Saturday shared a photograph of herself from the sets of Houseful 4, with the lovely ladies of Houseful 4 who really do get along because heroines fighting is so passe. She captioned the image. Produced by Sajid Nadiadwala, Houseful 4 marks the return of Sajid Khan as the director for the franchise. The film will also see Bobby reuniting with Akshay, with whom he has previously worked in many films. Houseful 4 is set for a Diwali 2019 release.
Karol Bagh Jewelers ਗਹਿਣਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਲੇਟੈਸਟ ਡਿਜ਼ਾਈਨ ਲਈ ਪਹਿਲੀ ਚੁਆਇਸ ਸੋਨੇ ਅਤੇ ਹੀਰੇ ਦੇ ਸੈੱਟ ਚੂੜੀਆਂ ਅਤੇ ਕੜੇ ਚੇਨ ਜੜਾਊ ਸੈੱਟ ਅਤੇ ਹੋਰ ਵੀ ਕਈ ਗਹਿਣਿਆਂ ਤੇ ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲ ਡਿਸਕਾਊਂਟ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਵੱਡੀ ਚੁਆਇਸ ਬਿਹਤਰੀਨ ਸਰਵਿਸ ਅਤੇ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਵਾਜਿਬ ਰੇਟਾਂ ਲਈ ਆਓ ਕਰੋਲ ਬਾਗ ਜਵੈਲਰਸ ਅਤੇ ਰੂਪ ਜਵੈਲਰਸ ਕਰੋਲ ਬਾਗ ਜਵੈਲਰਸ 1098 ਪੀਟਰ ਰੋਬਰਟਸਨ ਬੁਲੇਵਾਰਡ ਬ੍ਰੈਂਪਟਨ ਰੂਪ ਜਵੈਲਰਸ 503 ਰੇ ਲੋਸਨ ਬੁਲੇਵਾਰਡ ਬ੍ਰੈਂਪਟਨ